In this episode, we're looking at some important detergents for cell lysis and protein extraction. Whether you're extracting proteins in their native form or solubilizing proteins from isolated cell membranes, detergents are a vital part of this process. So let's explore a few key detergents and their properties that you might consider for your experiments. To start, let's look at how detergents are classified. Detergents can be classified based on their charge as zwitterionic, nonionic, cationic, or anionic. Each classification has specific uses, especially in terms of whether they denature proteins or not. Another key thing we have to consider is their critical micelle concentration, or CMC, which is essential for their effectiveness in experiments. This table here, which I'll also have linked below, summarizes the attributes of the detergents that I'll be talking about, along with their classification, whether they denature proteins, and their CMC. For non-denaturing detergents used to solubilize membranes, it's important to use them at concentrations higher than their CMC to effectively disrupt lipid layers. And again, I'll put a link to the article that has this table. That'll be in the description for you to use as a reference. So now let's dive into each detergent, their classifications, and their uses. We'll start off with CHAPS. CHAPS is a zwitterionic detergent that is non-denaturing and is excellent for purifying proteins, especially membrane-associated ones, in their native form. It's perfect for cell lysis and permeabilization while preserving the native structure of your sample proteins. Next up, we have chlorhexidine, chlorhexidine diacetate, and chlorhexidine HCl. These cationic detergents are particularly effective at lysing gram-negative bacterial cells due to their positive charge, which binds to the negatively charged bacterial cell walls. Deoxycholic acid, which is an anionic detergent, is often used in cell lysis buffers like RIPA buffer. It disrupts cell and nuclear membranes and is used to solubilize membrane proteins. This detergent is even used in the biotech industry to purify membrane proteins for vaccine production. Digitonin is a non-ionic detergent known for solubilizing lipids and is used in cell lysis to purify proteins or organelles in their native forms. It's also great for cell permeabilization without killing the cells. And finally, it can be useful in live cell labeling experiments. Last on the list are octylglucoside and octylthioglucoside. These are non-ionic detergents used to purify membrane proteins without disrupting protein-protein interactions. Their structure resembles membrane components, aiding in effective membrane disruption. And there you have it. It's all actually really easy once you understand how each detergent is classified and how it will function, as well as the unique advantages of each of these detergents. For a more detailed understanding of detergents, their classifications, and their critical micelle concentration, check out our comprehensive article, and that'll be linked below for you. Also, visit goldbio.com for more resources and also just affordable, really high quality reagents.